So now that we got the worst list out of the way, I'm going to start my top 10 best comics of the year. And we're going to start with indie comics. So that can come from Image, that can come from Black Mask, Aftershock, IDW, Boom, any company really that isn't the big two, isn't DC or Marvel. I really wanted to cover comics that I love this year from other companies. And before we get to the list, there's some honorable mentions I'm just going to mention real fast. Swing is a really fun slice of life romantic story about a couple who decides to start swinging. I mean, it's right in the title. Really fun, really enjoyable for people who loved Sunstone. This is one worth checking out. Days of Hate, really dark political story, I guess, and the only way to describe it, filled with extremists on both sides, and definitely an interesting take on it all, and very morbid, so just get ready for that. And another one I wanted to mention is Guide and Falls. Jeff Lemire does a great job with creating this dark and mysterious two worlds that are coming and colliding together. It's a great story, has a lot of mystery. I found that a lot of people like Outcast will probably enjoy this for the slow burn feel. Definitely worth checking out. Very cool series. And those are the ones I want to just mention off the top of my head for honorable mentions. Now let's get to my top 10 indie comics of the year. We're going to start at number 10 with Briggs Land. I think this is a great story. A bit political, but honestly, it's more about family. About a place in the middle of nowhere, Briggs Land, that's what it's called, who's run by kind of like these white supremacist type family. Now, that sounds crazy, right? But it has a bunch of twists and turns, as it's like mafia type setup, and it deals with the betrayal and the back-to-back life of this, not redneck, but really smart white supremacist type foundation or a village. Well, the first one started a while back. The newest edition did come out this year. I think it's just as good, if not better, and everybody should be checking out this series. Coming out number 9 is Royal City. If there was ever a slice of life series I'd recommend, it'd probably be Royal City. Jeff Lemire has done a great amount of indie titles this year, but this is probably my favorite of his. It's a deep look into the life of a family who is broken from the core, and they're trying to pick up the pieces. Each main character has a story to tell, and you kind of connect through various ones in different ways. Not to mention, I think it's the best use of Lemire's art, which usually I'm actually not a big fan of, but I think it works really well here for the tone and atmosphere. And yeah, Royal City is complete now. It has a great ending and it's very satisfying. I definitely say check it out. Coming in at number 8 is Ice Cream Man. Now this started off, this is an anthology of horror stories basically, and it started off pretty good, but I didn't love it. And then the volume 2 just came out like this month or last month, and it boosted it from pretty good series to amazing. I really loved the current 4 newest issues. It's really just a great horror series, but it has a lot of heart. It has a message. It talks about various different subjects in life in terms of depression, and it's great. It has this overall arcing story in the background of each issue that's semi-connecting. Characters are starting to link, but you can really just pick up each issue and you're going to get a great story in each one. So Ice Cream Man, check it out. It's the surprise hit of the year for me, and if you didn't like volume 1 or you just thought it was okay, stick with it because volume 2 is amazing. Coming in number 7 is Saga. Well, usually it's like in my number 1, 2, or 3 spot. This series is still amazing. Let me just say that. It's just that there's so many other amazing series this year for me, and I wanted to talk about them. So, what's here in the world of Saga? Well, I can't really tell you because this year it's a ton of spoilers. A lot of deaths and a lot of things. But let's just say after last year's shocking moments, this year is more about healing and becoming whole again and focusing on recovering and being a family. And of course, there's death in the end, and now we have a super long hiatus. It's a big cliffhanger at the end, so now we got to wait over a year to find out what's happening. But Saga won't be on my list next year, but it definitely deserves to be on the list this year, and it's amazing. Go check it out. It's on its 9th volume and still going super strong. Number 6 is Redneck. It's another great series that's only getting better. Oh, and whose name is on the title? That's right, it's Donny Cates again. Yeah, this guy is on my list. He's probably on all my lists except for DC because he hasn't written for DC. But yeah, Redneck is about vampires. Now, don't run away. I know vampires are overused, but it's amazing here. Redneck is this white trash family drama, twists and turns, nonstop, lots of deaths that you don't expect. I mean, this series just keeps ramping up to be everything you want And it's proving that you can put the cliches of the vampires and all these stories in every other comic, but it really works here. And God, Volume 2 somehow is as good, if not better, than Volume 1. It's worth checking out. And Volume 3 is coming in March, so check the series out. Get caught up. It's definitely worth it. All right, we get to my top five, and we're going to start off with Deadly Class. You're always going to see this series on my list as long as it keeps the quality that it's had in the last 2-3 years. This is just a fucking kick-ass series. It's the best way to say it. This one never stops being good, but the last volume to come out this year is just the balls-to-walls, action-packed insaneness, while the earlier one this year was kind of more of a slower beat, more emotional, character-driven moments. Deadly Class proves that you can just throw off these crazy action-top moments, but then you also have this sweet, emotional coming-of-age story with deaths coming every single issue and the cast growing bigger and then smaller and bigger and smaller. The stakes keep rising. Deadly Class is easily always going to be in my top five, and it keeps doing what it's doing. All right, number four is Kill or Be Killed. This is easily my favorite Brubaker and Sean Phillips series of all time, and that's saying a lot from these two legendary creators. This title made my list last year. I think it actually won, but it finishes this year, and it's extremely strong. An ending that you might not see coming, a strong character connection to almost the whole cast, and a heart-racing last few issues that leave our characters in the most fucked up situations. Man, oh man, I could have gone another 2-3 volumes. Kill or Be Killed is definitely a classic for me, something I'm going to read over and over again in my life, and you guys got to check it out. Coming in number three is Invincible, and while the only really like one or two issues really covered this year and then it was done, it's the last volume that came out this year, and I have to say, even if it was just the last issue that came out this year, it's worth on my list. This is a goodbye in the best fashion, giving all the characters the justice they deserve and saying goodbye to a cast that was with me for over 8 years. You know, it's a long time the series has been running. Mark will always be one of my favorite superheroes of all time. The trials and tribulations that he had to go through growing as a superhero, but also living his life and growing and marrying and having a kid, all just wonderful, and the long-running 25 volumes that the series provided. Invincible made me personally want to be a comic writer, and it was just so good to see a powerful and perfect ending. In my opinion, the last issue is perfection. So thank you, Robert Kirkman. I think this is by far your best series and the series that will always stick with me. Number two is Baby Teeth. Talk about a knockout. Well, I didn't get a chance to really get to this title till this year, and I know it began in 2017. It's just amazing. Donnie Cates proves again that this writer just puts out something all the time we're talking about. And he takes the simple premise of a girl giving birth to Satan, and now this Satan is a baby. So yes, it is similar to something else you might have heard of. But now she's raising and protecting it from these crazy religious people. The twists and turns again come out from nowhere, just like Redneck. But I think what makes this better than Redneck is that I love every single character. The cast in this is so damn good. So that's the one thing it has over Redneck. They're both crazy, both insane stories, so many great twists, and I need more. So Baby Teeth, please keep being good. You are my number two this year. I think you might hit number one next year. Let's go for it. And coming at number one is Sync, Welcome to Glasgow. I hope I'm saying that right. Glasgow? I'm sorry if I'm saying wrong. My biggest surprise of the year by far. Another horror anthology series, basically all set in one town, the Glasgow. I feel like I'm saying that wrong. I'm probably going to get yelled at. But it's all different stories that loosely connect with each other. Each story gives a different vibe and atmosphere, which is really cool. John Lee expertly crafts each story to let us know what type of town that you're in. And also, he somehow hits those coming-of-age stories and also focusing on this awesome character named Mr. Diggs, who is basically this fucking guy wearing a gigantic fox hat or fox not hat mask thing, and it's scary, but it's also badass, and you also root for him even though he's doing disturbing things to the people who are worse than him. I really recommend this for all horror fans and just comic fans in general. This is probably the most indie title on here. It's not produced by Image or Boom or anything, but it blew me away. When I finished this, I just was like, whoa, this comic is worth reading right now. I gave it a 5 out of 5. I think it's one of the best comics of the entire year. I really recommend everybody checking this one out. And hopefully you enjoy it as much as I did, because I absolutely loved it. And that wraps up my top 10 indie comics of the year. Some you might have heard of, some you're like, what is that? And now you got to go check it out because it's definitely worth checking out. There's so many indie titles, though, that I didn't even get to read or catch up on. Unfortunately, I didn't finish or catch up on Harrow County, Descender. Just so many. Black Hammer. I'm far behind some, and I just didn't have time to catch up. But these 10 right here just were so great that they were probably always going to be on my list. List yours of indie comics. That can be from any company, no matter how small the company, or even if it's self-published, all the way to Image, which probably be the biggest third-party or self-publishing company. But anyway, I'm going to stop talking. Check it out. Hope you enjoyed the video. Hit like if you did. Share it with people. Enjoy it. Pick up these comics. Any questions about these comics, let me know. I'll link them below so you can pick them up. And thank you. Have a great day. I'm going to get a better ending one day.